everybody, my name is Dark Cheetah, and welcome to Five Nights at Freddy's 2. Alright, let's just get started. I am not looking forward to this. Grand reopening! Vintage pizzeria given new life. Yay. What could go wrong? I can name a lot of things that could go wrong. I mean, look at those stupid-looking animatronics. I mean, seriously. Eh. Alright. From what I know about this game, I know that the old animatronics don't come out until the second night. Neither does Mangle, I think. Still have the... Sorry, back with my Dr. Pepper. We still have to worry about Mangle... Or no, not Mangle. The puppet, Toy Chica, Toy Bonnie. And that's about it? I think? Good God, these nights take forever to load. Ugh.
Down this new and exciting career path. Now, I want you to forget anything you may have heard about the old location, you know. Some people still have a somewhat negative impression of the company. That old restaurant was kind of left to rot for quite a while, but I want to reassure you, Fazbear Entertainment is committed to family fun and above all, safety. They've spent a small fortune on these new animatronics. Facial recognition, advanced mobility, they even let them walk around during the day. Isn't that neat? But most importantly, they're all tied into some kind of criminal database so they can detect a predator a mile away. Heck, we should be paying them to guard you. Now that being said, no new system is without its kinks. You're only the second guard to work at that location. The first guy finished his week but complained about conditions. We switched him over to the day shift. So, hey, lucky you, right? Mainly he expressed concern that certain characters seemed to move around at night and even attempted to get into his office. Now, from what we know, that should be impossible. That restaurant should be the safest place on Earth. So, while our engineers don't really have an explanation for this, the working theory is that the robots were never given a proper night mode. So, when it gets quiet, they think they're in the wrong room. So then they go try to find where the people are, and in this case, that's your office.
This is
so our temporary solution is that there's a music box over by the prize counter, and it's rigged to be wound up remotely. So just every once in a while, switch over to the prize counter video feed and wind it up for a few seconds. It doesn't seem to affect all of the animatronics, but it does affect one of them.
One of them.
And as for the rest of them, we have an even easier solution.
Why do I keep having
You see, there may be a minor glitch in the system, something about robots seeing you as an endoskeleton without a costume on and wanting to stuff you into a suit.
Yeah,
so hey, we've given you an empty Freddy Fazbear head. Problem solved. You can put it on any time and leave it on for as long as you want. Eventually, anything that wandered in will wander back out. Something else worth mentioning is kind of the quirky modern design of the building. You may have noticed there are no doors for you to close. But hey, you have a light, and even though your flashlight can run out of power, the building cannot. So don't worry about the place going dark.
Okay, so I can't...
Well, I think that's it. You should be going. Check the lights, put on the Freddy head if you need to, keep the music box wound up, piece of cake. Have a good night, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Bonnie's gone. Oh, hi, Bonnie. I still can't close the camera. That is a problem that keeps occurring. I don't like it. And Chica's gone. Oh, Bonnie's there. Chica. Angle's still here. How you guys? Yeah, I'm about to get jump scared. Camera not going down because it's 6 a.m. I have no idea why that keeps happening. I always thought it was night one that was... Okay. I have no idea how I'm... Okay. First thing first, I am not flipping down that camera. Flipping up that camera yet. I said I don't have to worry about power. Let me go see what my new stepdad person thing wants, whatever, I don't know. I have to make my dinner after this. I haven't had dinner yet. Whatever, it's only 7:12. We're going to ignore that.
Hello? See, I told you your first night wouldn't be a problem. You're a natural. Now I'm sure you've noticed the older models sitting in the back room. Those are from the previous location, and we just use them for parts now.
Uh-oh.
The idea at first was to repair them. They even started retrofitting them with some of the newer technology. But they were just so ugly, you know?
They're not ugly. How dare you say that about the old Imatron?
So the company decided to just go in a whole new direction and make them super kid friendly. Those older ones shouldn't be able to walk around, but if they do, the whole Freddy head trick should work on them too. So whatever.
Sure.
I love those old characters. Did you ever see Foxy the Pirate? Oh wait, Foxy. Oh yeah, Foxy. Hey, listen.
Yeah,
that one was always a bit twitchy. I'm not sure if the Freddy head trick will work on Foxy. If for some reason he activates during the night, and you see him standing at the far end of the hall, just flash your light at him from time to time. Those older models would always get disoriented with bright light. It would cause a system restart or something. Come to think of it, you might want to try that on any room where something undesirable might be. It might hold him in place for a few seconds. That glitch might have carried over to the newer models, too. One more thing. Don't forget the music box. I'll be honest, I never liked that puppet thing. It's always thinking, and it can go anywhere.
I know Mangle's deal. Mangle's
I don't think
the
gray
mask
will fool it, so just don't forget the music box. Anyway, I'm sure it won't be a problem.
The music box.
Have a good night, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.
I heard someone. You. I know Mangle's deal is the flashlight. Get out of here, Mangle. Okay, that's just right, Freddy. that'd be good. Stupid puppet! I'll admit, that scared the ever-living daylights out of me. Hi, old Freddy. Withered Freddy is your name. Alright, we'll give it one more go in night two. That would be my phone call. Student schedules. Okay. Sorry, school stuff is happening. Mom wants to talk to me. That's why my phone is ringing. Don't know if you could hear it. I'll call her back after this. We'll work on night three and however many of that next episode. Who knew that everyone would need me? I have never had that happen before. You know what? My editing skills are sucky, so you're just gonna have to live with it. Get a bit into my life, since really the only one watching this is Toby anyways. I can even check the subscriber count on my phone while I'm waiting for this to load, because I can do things like that. Oh. Yeah, see, I have 45 subscribers. No fun. I mean, it's fun, it's good, it's great, I love it. Here, let me check my channel settings on. Good lord, these things take a long while to load. No, I can't check. Oh! We're live! Sort of. Oh man, I want the phone guy to come back. And I'm lagging again. I think I know what it was, is that I was angle. Okay, we're gonna not worry about all that. We're gonna focus on you. Problem child of the group. Ding ding. You can't get Funtime Freddy's nose. I didn't know that. Can my phone guy come back? Like every time you die. More Golden Freddy on the wall. There's a train coming. Chica kill me of all. Well, at least I didn't die on the first night. I don't know if I just... Who? Someone's here. Who's here? Thanks, police box, you ain't here yet. Gosh darn it! No, no, why not have been jumped by Foxy now? So we can add Bonnie. So my total list of jump scares is Bonnie, Golden Freddy, technically. Alright, well, we'll talk jump scares next episode. I gotta end this here, sadly. Okay, we'll get to night 3 and beat night 2 next episode. I hate this game already. Alright. Sorry to cut this video short. I don't know how long it is off the top of my head. Probably 20 minutes. Anyways, I will see you on the next episode. Goodbye.